everyone, Kamar Juba, and welcome to Tamada's table. This is Tamada. I am Tatiana. It's spring, it's Easter time, and I'll show you today how to make a very special dish which Georgians make for Easter. Chakapuli lamb cooked with tarragon and unripe green tkemali plums. Do Georgians cook chakapuli only once a year? Of course not, my friends. We cook it whenever we want it, but this Easter chakapuli is very special because it's made with spring lamb and the first tarragon and tkemali of this season. And Georgians still prefer and eat seasonal food which they buy from local farmers. Also, chakapuli kind of symbolizes the transition of the seasons, warm weather, spring awakening, guests, smiles, new hopes and beginnings. Let's begin! And you'll see that my colors today are mostly green, except for the meat. Chakapuli is typically made with lamb or sometimes with veal. Although some people prefer chicken and even mushrooms, see the mushrooms with tarragon recipe at Tamada's table. 3 pounds of lamb, which I bought at butcher's shop, it's already cut into 3-inch cubes. We will need white wine, dry white wine, 2 cups chopped green onions, 2 garlic cloves minced, 2 cups coarsely chopped tarragon leaves, 1 cup finely chopped cilantro, 1/2 green chili pepper, I'll be using jalapeno, you can use any chili pepper you have on hand, 15 tkemali plums or 2 tablespoons fresh lemon juice. About tkemali. Fresh tkemali, it's very hard to find in the US, so I was lucky. I found a jar of marinated tkemali, which I ordered online. Even in Georgia, the season for tkemali is very short until it is unripe, and we will be using green unripe tkemali. So about 15 tkemali, if you don't have tkemali, just substitute it with 2 tablespoons of fresh lemon juice. And we will need some salt to flavor the stew. The pot is on medium heat and I'm adding the meat. Close the cover and cook for 15 minutes until the meat releases the juices. I washed the green onions and I chopped off the tops and the bottoms, so now I will just chop them. And we use green and white parts, so don't throw anything away. I have approximately 2 cups and I will use it all. Now I will prepare tarragon. And what I will do with the tarragon, I already washed it, but now I will first cut off the ends of the stalks. This is actually French tarragon, Georgian. Tarragon is slightly different, but the taste of the stew will be the same. I'm almost done with tarragon. I'm trimming the leaves, and the easiest way to do it is this way. Just like that. Let's chop them. Oh, this one stalk I don't need. Like that. That's all, because this all will be cooking in the pot. So we don't need to really chop it finely. Now let's measure. So I have about 2 cups of tarragon here. So let's chop cilantro. We just need 1 cup. Again, you don't have to chop it really finely because it will be all cooking. We just need the flavor. Here is my a little bit more than 1 cup of cilantro, but this is fine. It's been 15 minutes. Let's check on our meat. It's cooking very well. You see the juice which the meat released? And this juice will enhance the stew. Now I will flavor it more with wine. 1 cup of white wine. Close the lid and cook for another 15 minutes on a low heat. After cilantro, I will slice jalapeno pepper thinly. This is light stew, so you should do it like really, really thinly, as thin as you can. Just half of it for now, you can always add. But this stew doesn't need a lot of fire in it. Put in the bowl, next to the herbs, and continue with the garlic. I just degermed the garlic because, again, this is kind of like light stew, and if you don't degerm the garlic, it can be a little bit harsh. So what I do, I just cut it like half and get this green out. And then mince the garlic. My garlic is ready. My fresh herbs are all chopped and jalapeno pepper is sliced. So it's time to check on the meat. It's been 15 minutes. Let's check my meat. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Wah, 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 like Georgians saying. Wah means delight. When Georgians are saying this word, yes, it's excellent. Time to add other ingredients. Actually, all ingredients. That's why chakapuli is easy to make. Green onions go into the pot. Tarragon. Garlic. Pepper. Cilantro. And tkemali. Here it is. Now we can mix it. Add 2 cups of boiling water. Why I'm adding boiling water? Because it won't stop the cooking process. If I add cold water, it will stop the cooking process. A pinch of... Let's stir it well. Yes. See how everything blends together. Now I will add a good pinch of salt. Of course, I will be adjusting the flavors at the end, but a good pinch of coarse salt, and cover and cook for another 40 minutes or until the lamb is fork tender. It's been 40 minutes, time to check on my chakapuli, and the first thing I'll do, I'll check on the meat if it's fork tender, and I see that it is really, really tender. Very good. If it's not tender, then you can cook additional 10-15 minutes until it's really tender, but this one is done, so I'll just serve it in a bowl. My chakapuli is ready and I'll be enjoying it. So let's cut the piece of meat and see how it is. Mmm, so tender and delicious, really yummy. And now let's try some juice. Wah, 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 as Georgians say, this is really good. But don't forget that this stew is may have pits from tkemali, so just put them aside, be careful while you are eating. And this is stew full of liquid which was cooked with aromatic herbs and wine and tkemali, and this is kind of elegant stew. So what I will do, I will also have elegant Georgian wine. Cilantro is made from 2 indigenous grapes varieties that grow in Tahiti region, which is the main wine growing region in Georgia. And toast to all of you, my friends, to beautiful, beautiful season of spring and wonderful, happy Easter. Bon appetit! Gabrielat Mir!